So if you are just joining us, South Korea leading the tie, this semi-final, playing for a place in the final. They're 1-0 up in the overall match. And this is the start of the first men's doubles. So Lee and Yu have played three and won three. They might be just that little bit sharper than Ahsan and Setiawan, who've only played two and won one.
Serves over 1-0. 2-1.
Well, they've all got their business faces on. They're all very focused. But it's which team can keep on the attack. Basically, that's what good doubles is about, keeping that one up, one back situation.
Service over. 2-4.
Well, the four most experienced doubles players in the world going toe to toe here on court two. I can tell you there's an Uber Cup match over on court one adjacent, and that's what all the hullabaloo's all about. It's really, obviously the match is young because they started at the same time as us, but Lee Jure is doing battle with Sen and Ewal, and they're locked in the early in the third and deciding game over there of the opening singles. That, like us, are all playing for a place in the final as well. China, the strong favourites, as they are against whoever they play in the women's event. So deadlock here still. 3-3. Oh, nice from Ahsan. So deceptive.
5-3.
Take a look at it again. Here it comes. Oh, we were obscured there by Setiawan at the net. But perhaps that's the reason why the opponents didn't read it as well. Wonderful little flick.
Set over. 4-5.
Above the waist, fourth goal.
Team
Korea disputing it. First fourth goal of this match. Well, I guess one of the talking points here is how undercooked are Ahsan and Setiawan, having only played twice. They might be wonderfully fresh as a consequence, but not jaded physically. Oh, blistering pace. couple of smashes. You couple that with some wonderful touch around the net, and there you have the second best pairing in the world playing such effective, varied badminton. Flat, hard drive right into the body of you, mercilessly. Really got hold of this. Look at that. Caught everybody by surprise, that one. Again, struck above the waist. A very stern look on the service judge's face. Well, twice. In what, 5 points? Service point court. So, plenty to ponder then going into the mid-game interval. World number one's Lee Yu trailing marginally. Just a 3 point deficit. They'll need to recover. Legs to keep warm, perhaps to aid the sore back, possibly.
9-11.
Wonderful response from Yong Dae. Far from you, I should say. Hendra Setiawan, such a force around the net when he's that close. He's just with his big wingspan as well at 5'11". He's tricky to get the shuttle past. Mohamed Ahsan at the back is, they just complement each other so well, and they can play both back and front court with equal effect.
13, 10.
Oh, that's a gorgeous slice.
14-10.
So deceptive.
Seven.
5-point cushion now. The top seeds seemingly feeling the pressure. Chasing into the body of Yu, just couldn't reflect anything back when he's so good. It just had that little injection of extra pace from Ahsan.
Sets over. 12,
these guys
16.
Have got almost extra sensory powers, haven't they? The way that they perceive the shuttle so quickly. Light years. Really, really quick reflexes. Fast hand to eye coordination. So good at turning defense into attack, frankly, as well. Still, it's the Indonesians with the marginal upper hand. Standing ovation from several of them as Ahsan really came alive there with a renewed intensity. Well, they won their last showing in December 2015 of the Dubai World Super Series Finals, of course, to Ahsan and Setiawan. 21-15 in the deciding game. They lost 2 days earlier in the Group A stages of the same event in straight games. Oh, that's nice. Just done with 19, ease, and grace, and time, and calm. They also beat Lian Yu in the final, did Ahsan and Setiawan of the BWF World Championships of 2015, back in August. Thunderous power from you. Crashed it down the line.
15-20.
One game point safe. We'll make that two now. Found the line according to the Lions judge. Lee is not wanting to challenge. He must have been convinced as well. Yeah, on the inside of the line, I'd say he just turns around to has a glance at the line's judge, but there was hands down. So after a quarter of an hour then, Ahsan and Setiawan from Indonesia take the opening game of this critical, pivotal match in the overall tie. And to remind you, if you have just turned your telly on, however you're choosing to watch this, on your laptop, your tablet or whatever, Team Indonesia lost the opening match because Son Wanho took out Jonathan Christie in straight games. 21-10, 21-16 after just 34 minutes. A good experience for the youngster who are putting himself particularly well in the second game. Like a couple of married couples, these four, aren't they? Spent so much time on the road together at tournaments, on the court. And of course, when you go through the fire together of competitive badminton, you really do find a relationship. What an atmosphere building on the adjacent court. Li Jure is serving for the match. Three match points against Sen and Ewal, China, India, Uber Cup. So, can these two keep a stranglehold and a headlock over their opponents in purple and blue? The Koreans, the other end. Or will Korea fight back as they do so well? Last night, remember, they say 3-0. Second game then, Indonesia, a game for the good. Here he goes, and as he pushes off, he just couldn't quite get any traction. A calm on the match court, doesn't he? Very assured. It's a brilliant lead from Mohammed Ahsan.
Over. 4-2.
light of this man, Ahsan. They're under a lot of pressure there, pummeling smashes, but that one just dribbled over the net. So they stay in touch in this slightly trickier end to play with the subtle drift on their back, so they can't punch the clears quite as firmly. Silky hand skills to be able to just touch that over so delicately. Such a tight net shot here. Even Yu, with all of his speed, couldn't dig that one out. Anticipated another tightly contested game. These two, the older, just a little bit more experienced than 31 years of age, managing their opponents so effectively. Jump just prior to the smash as well, as if to say, I'm going to hit it thunderously, but not so. Taking all the pace out, just delightful to watch. Of men that are totally and utterly consumed with what they do. One point at a time is all that matters. Yeah. look at this. Red lines at that one, takes the speed out of that one for a clean winner. Fabulous skills. Just a treat to watch when they're in full flow, as indeed Lee Yong Dae and Yu Yong Seong. But it's Ahsan and Setiawan who have control of this match. Desperate to avenge that 5-7 trailing head-to-head. Winning today. Separate them, and it's the white and red team that are leading. Too generous a clear, despite having the drift on his face, spills long over the back line. This a doable recovery? Well, you'd have to say absolutely yes for the world number ones, the Koreans. Oh, but lady luck again, falling the way of Mohammed Ahsan. Slow play. I need you to speed up. Thank you. thunderous.
He's
only 5'8".
17.
Doesn't he give it a rip though when he really wants to, Mohammed Ahsan? Four points away from the W now to level up this tie. Oh, you see again, that is just deceptively awesome. Devastating effect on the opponents. Look at this. It's just cheeky. That's what it is. Been brilliant today. They've orchestrated the play from the off. And have been at times unplayable.
20.
Sheer class. 11. 9 match point opportunities. They've kept the Koreans out of the match through very effective patterns of play. Long. Thank heavens for you, because that would have been quite embarrassing had it landed in on match point down. Very, very well left. So, still another 8 match point opportunities for the world number 2s. Brilliant. Look at what it meant to Ahsan. Delighted at the end of that one. Second match point opportunity was what it took, and they get it done. 21-15, 21-12, in a very well-played encounter. 34 minutes was all that it took, and that is a great performance. The head-to-head then goes to 6-7 in favour of Lee and Yu. But, more importantly, they level this semi-final tie. What are they playing for? Well, it's all at stake. A place in the Thomas Cup final tomorrow. We've got the second men's singles coming up shortly. Standing ovation from several of them as Ahsan really came alive there with a renewed intensity. Well, they won their last showing in December 2015 of the Dubai World Super Series Finals, of course, to Ahsan and Setiawan. 21-15 and the deciding game. that. They lost 2 days earlier in the Group A stages of the same event in straight games. Just done with
19,
ease,
19.
And grace, and time, and calm. They also beat Lian Yu in the final, did Ahsan and Setiawan of the BWF World Championships of 2015, back in August. Thunderous power from you. Crashed it down the line.
15-20.
And one game point safe. We'll make that two now. Found the line according to the Lions judge. Lee is not wanting to challenge.
No,
he must have been convinced as well. Yeah, on the inside of the line, I'd say he just turns around to has a glance at the Lions judge, but there was hands down. So after a quarter of an hour then, Ahsan and Setiawan from Indonesia take the opening game of this critical, pivotal match in the overall tie. And to remind you, if you have just turned your telly on, however you're choosing to watch this on your laptop, your tablet or whatever, Team Indonesia lost the opening match because Son Wanho took out Jonathan Christie in straight games. 21-10, 21-16 after just 33 minutes. A good experience for the youngster who acquitted himself particularly well in the second game. They're like a couple of married couples, these four, aren't they? Spent so much time on the road together at tournaments, on the court. And of course, when you go through the fire together of competitive badminton, you really do building on the adjacent court. Li Jure is serving for the match. Three match points against Sen and Ewal, China, India, Uber Cup.
20 seconds. 20 seconds.
So, can these two keep a stranglehold and a headlock over their opponents in purple and blue? The Koreans, the other end. Will Korea fight back as they do so well?
Same
last
game.
Night, remember, they say 3 points
in
doubles. Second game then, Indonesia a game for the good.
6.
So as anticipated, another tightly contested game.
8-6.
The older, just a little bit more experienced, 31 years of age. managing their opponents so effectively. Teasing them into error with a wonderful slice.
9-6.
Such a clever little jump just prior to the smash as well, as if to say, I'm going to hit it thunderously, but not so. Taking all the pace out, just delightful to watch. Of men that are totally and utterly consumed with what they do. One point at a time is all that matters. Oh, they're the kings of variety. Incredible. That rally had it all. Look at this. Red lines at that one, takes the speed out of that one for a clean winner. Fabulous skills. Just a treat to watch when they're in full flow, as indeed are Lee Yong Dae and Yu Yong Seong. But it's Ahsan and Setiawan who have control of this match. Desperate to avenge that 5-7 trailing head-to-head. Winning today. Separate them, and it's the white and red team that are leading. Too generous a clear, despite having the drift on his face, it spills long over the back line. This a doable recovery? Well, you'd have to say absolutely yes for the world number ones, the Koreans. Oh, but lady luck again, falling the way of Mohammed Ahsan. Slow play. I need you to speed up.
Serve's over.
joining us. South Korea leading the tie, this semi-final. Playing for a place in the final. They're 1-0 up in the overall match. And this is the start of the first men's doubles.
Set over, 1-0.
So Lee and Yu have played 3 and 1-3. They might be just that little bit sharper than Ahsan and Setiawan, who have only played 2 and 1-1.
Set over, 1-0.
Business faces on, they're all very focused. Which team can keep on the attack, basically. That's what good doubles is about, keeping that one up, one back situation. Well, the four most experienced doubles players in the world going toe to toe here on court two. Well, I can tell you there's an Uber Cup match over on court one adjacent, and that's what all the hullabaloo's all about. It's really, obviously the match is young because they started at the same time as us, but Lee Jure is doing battle with Sen and Ewal, and they're locked in the early in the third and deciding game over there of the opening singles. That, like us, are all playing for a place in the final as well. China, the strong favourites, as they are against whoever they play in the women's event. So deadlock here still. 3-3. Oh, nice from Ahsan. So deceptive.
5-3.
Take a look at it again. Here it comes. Oh, we were obscured there by Setiawan at the net. But perhaps that's the reason why the opponents didn't read it as well. Wonderful little flick.
Set over. 4-5.
Above the waist, fourth goal.
Team
Korea disputing it. First fourth goal of this match.
Seven. Four.
Well, I guess one of the talking points here is how undercooked are Ahsan and Setiawan, having only played twice. They might be wonderfully fresh as a consequence, not jaded physically. Oh, blistering pace, couple of smashes, you couple that with some wonderful touch around the net. And there you have the second best pairing in the world playing such effective, varied badminton. Here he goes. Then as he pushes off, he just couldn't quite get any traction. Calm on the match court, doesn't he? Very assured. Somehow, to the delight of this man, Ahsan, you're under a lot of pressure there, pummeling smashes, but that one just dribbled over the net. So they stay in touch in this slightly trickier end to play with the subtle drift on their back, so they can't punch the clears quite as firmly. Sees this, so quick to pounce. I mean, that is just silky hand skills to be able to just touch that over so delicately. Such a tight net shot here. Even you, with all of his speed, couldn't dig that one out. That serve. Flat, hard drive, right into the body of you, mercilessly. Really got hold of this, look at that. Cool, everybody was surprised that one. Again, struck above the waist. A very stern look on the service judge's face. Well, twice. In what, 5 points? Service point court. So, plenty to ponder then going into the mid-game interval. World number one's Lee Yu trailing marginally. It's just a 3 point deficit. It's one in which they'll need to recover. Legs to keep warm, perhaps to aid the sore back, possibly.
9-11.
Wonderful response from Lee Yong Dae. Or from you, I should say. Hendra, Setiawan, such a force around the net when he's that close. He's just, with his big wingspan as well at 5'11", he's tricky to get the shuttle past. Mohamed Ahsan at the back is, they just complement each other so well, and they can play both back and front court with equal effect.
13, 10.
Oh, that's a gorgeous slice.
14-10.
So deceptive. Body of you just couldn't reflect anything back when he's so good. It just had that little injection of extra pace from Ahsan.
Sets over 12.
These guys have got almost extra sensory powers, haven't they? The way that they perceive the shuttle so quickly. Light years.